Welcome back to the TD Club. We're here at Dr. Govicini Stadium, Chestnut Ridge High School, and we're going to preview the big District 5-6 Class AA game between Chestnut Ridge. We have Coach Max Shoemaker. Max, thanks for having us here. And we have Coach Kevin Steele from Bedford. Thanks for coming over, making the trip. We know you have practice, so we'll try to get you through this quick. This game is so important in the standings in District 5-6 Class AA. It's still a regular season game in Week 10, but points are at stake here for a playoff berth. Bedford, you guys are in ninth place at this point. Chestnut Ridge is in seventh. Bedford with 5-4 record. Chestnut Ridge 6-3 with 6 straight wins. Kevin, what do you have to do? I'm assuming it's got to be a win to have a chance to get in for you guys this week.
Always certainly need to win this week. It's a huge game. Obviously, it's just some added incentive on top of the local rivalry, and it's senior night for our kids. So we just need to go out and play to the best of our ability, and hopefully find the result we're looking for.
And you're going up against the Chestnut Ridge team. They've won 6 straight. They've dealt with some adversity this year. They've really put things together. When you look at their lineup, what are some of the things that you have to prepare to stop this week?
Well, certainly they're very explosive offensively. They've done a nice job throwing the football and also running the football. Hanks is a very good high school quarterback, so we know what we're up against. We need to make sure we do a good job of trying to slow them down. Hopefully we can put up some points as well.
Max, you guys, this is a county rivalry year in and year out. This is such a huge game in Bedford County. You're traveling over to their place. What do you think it's going to be like, and what are you going to have to prepare for?
Well, I think obviously we play Bedford, so it raises the intensity level to a higher competition. And, it's a challenge every year, and, our kids always look forward to that opportunity. And, we know we have to bring our A game, and Bedford's a very formidable opponent and has played in the Laurel Highlands, and we know that level of competition well.
And when you look at their similar situation at quarterback, he had mentioned Brad Hanks for you guys, and Bedford, another 3-year starter at quarterback, Marcus Shippey. What do you have to prepare for whenever you have a guy like that?
Well, Marcus is multidimensional. I mean, his running ability, he throws the ball well, and defensively, people overlook the impact he has on their defense. Bedford has many other weapons as well. I think he started with their offensive and defensive fronts is a real strength for them. And they have some good skill kids, particularly the Campbell boy out wide, and he's put up big numbers with some 10 touchdown receptions, I think, and 30-some receptions. We need to minimize the big play of Bedford and hold them in their offensive and defensive fronts.
And Coach Shoemaker had mentioned Campbell. I saw him against Johnstown, the game at your place. He had a huge play with the big kickoff return, but he's also a great receiver. Tell me a little bit about what he does and some of the other weapons you have.
Well, certainly Luke has been a great addition to our team. He's actually Marcus's cousin. He just came up from Hyman here over the offseason, has worked very hard in the summer and also obviously in the fall. He's been a great addition, does some nice things for us on both sides of the ball on special teams as well. Now, with that being said, we have some other kids that are nice weapons on both sides of the ball. Dakota Hess is another kid that has good speed. We're hoping that he'll be back and ready to go for this week. He's just getting back in the flow of things after being injured at Penn Cambria, but we're optimistic with a couple of our playmakers that hopefully they can play well and do some good things on the offensive side of the ball.
Defensively, you have the area leader in sacks. Swartz has 10 sacks. What does he do so well?
Well, Brad's a very good athlete. I mean, he's tall and lanky, and he's a tough kid to block. He has a motor that never stops, and he's an intelligent kid. He's very coachable, and he's just a pleasure to have as part of our defense. Just does a very good job of handling our defense.
Max, you've been on both sides. You coached at Bedford for many years. You've been here for quite a while now. What do you expect Friday night in terms of the atmosphere and the fans that are there and just what it'll be like in terms of intensity?
Well, it'll be exciting. These community members work together, and our kids date some of their kids, and their kids date some of ours. So there's a lot on the line, and bragging rights, I guess, would probably be the most important thing for the next year.
Well, there you have it, another episode of TD Club. We want to thank both Coach Kevin Steele and Coach Max Shoemaker for taking time out of their busy schedule to appear on the show. Thank you.